Inspector West. Calling Chief Inspector West.
Stand by for West. A crime file, based on John Creasey's novel, Battle for Inspector West. Dramatised for radio by Maurice Travers. Battle for Inspector West, starring Patrick Allen as Chief Inspector Roger West of Scotland Yard and Sarah Lawson as his wife Janet. Part 1. Honeymoon Spells Nightmare.
Belgravia 437... Yes, Mr. Michael Grant's apartment. What name shall I say? I'm sorry, sir, but unless I have your name, I'm afraid I...
Is that for me, Hayden?
Yes, sir, but the gentleman won't give his name.
Oh, won't he? Give me the phone. Hello? Grant speaking. Who's that? No, I do not. And I have a constitutional aversion to people who play funny beggars on the telephone, sir. Good grief. Hayden, that'll be all for the moment. Shut the door as you go out.
Very good, sir.
What? Yes, I'm still here. I didn't think you'd have the gall to come back to England, let alone phone me. Your congratulations? On what? Yes, I am. Yes, the wedding's the day after tomorrow. Now, if that's all you've... What? Her father, you slimy little... Now, get this straight. I know all about her father, and it doesn't matter a damn to her or to me, understand? So if you so much as try any of your rotten... Yes, by the powers, I'm warning you. History won't repeat itself. Next time, I'll come with a gun. That's a promise. The swine. The vicious swine.
Roger! Breakfast! Oh, the kettle. Roger!
Coming.
This minute, please. I'm dishing up. Oh, Roger! Oh,
right, Jan. Mmm. Oh, smells good.
Sit you down.
Yes, ma'am. Where are the boys? Hey, Scoopy, fish!
No, they've already had breakfast. I let you sleep on a bit after the time you got home last night. Your sons are up in the playroom with that train set you gave them last Christmas. You may be Scotland Yard's youngest, smartest chief inspector, but that, if I may say so, Mr. West, was not one of your brighter notions.
We all make mistakes. Route the boys out, Jan. They'll be late.
Not if they can spin things out long enough so that Dad has to give them a lift in the car.
Oh, cunning young demons. Marvellous, isn't it? 11 and 10, and as crafty as they make them already.
Well, heredity, well out. After all, they've a copper for their father. Ready for tea?
Anytime you like.
Here you are. I've sugared it for you.
Oh, thanks.
I wish you didn't have to work so hard.
Well, it's no worse for me than any other copper. The motto of the force these days, overworked and understaffed, but we go marching on.
Yes, but even so, you've no need to drive yourself quite so much, darling. If what you're after is to finish up being the Yard's youngest assistant commissioner as well, there's still lots of time, surely. Sir Guy Chatworth can stay put in his office for a while yet, can't he?
As long as he likes. Oh, now that's no job for me, Jan. I'm not cut out to be a desk-bound policeman. Any more tea in the pot?
Yes, of course. Yes, well, all the same, it wouldn't hurt you to take an hour off once in a while. Today, at lunchtime, for instance. It just so happens that I'm going to be in the West End. There's an exhibition of American paintings at the Markham Galleries, and I think it would be nice if you took me out for lunch. Roger.
Hmm?
I don't believe you're even listening.
That's a date.
What?
For lunch.
Oh! Well, talk about a girl having the wind taken out of her sails. Here was I, all set for a battle.
Meet me outside St. Catherine's Church, 12 o'clock. After that, we'll go on to lunch.
Lovely. What on earth will you be doing outside St. Catherine's? Don't tell me the vicar's had his fingers in the poor box.
Oh, nothing poor about the parishioners in that district, my dear girl. Now, I'll be there because, I'd like to take a look at a wedding.
You? Look at a wedding? What's come over you? It was as much as you could do to be in time for your own.
Well, it's a far cry from the marriage of an impecunious, newly appointed detective constable to the knot that's being tied at noon today for Michael Grant, Esquire, no less.
Michael Grant?
Mm. Son of the millionaire.
Sir Mortimer Grant?
That's right. The big business bigwig.
Oh.
A chairman of half a dozen huge companies on the board of a dozen others.
Yes, of course. His name's always in the papers.
And young Grant hits the headlines nearly as often as his father in the same line of country. All off his own bat. They say he's well on the way to his own first million, and with no help from Dad.
Oh, really? And who's the lucky girl?
Her name's Christine Morley. Very pretty, by all accounts. About 10 years younger than he is.
And just why, precisely, are you so interested in this wedding?
Oh, call it, idle curiosity. And just what is that intended to mean, may I ask?
I've been married to you for 12 years, Chief Inspector West, and the day you do a thing like this out of purely idle curiosity...
What's the time? Good Lord, 8:30. I'll have to be off. And if those monsters of ours want to lift to the school, well, they'd better hurry. Scoopy, fish! Jan, love, in front of St. Catherine's at 12.
Right.
Martin, Richard, come on, you two. Downstairs and at the double.
Cool, what a crowd! Here, mind you pushing if you please.
Oh, sorry, I'm looking for someone.
Oh, listen, they're coming!
Jan! Over here, Jan!
Excuse me. Do you mind if I get through? Oh, Roger, I'm sorry. I'm not too late, am I?
No, no, all's well.
Oh, there they are! Oh, look, there they are!
Oh, Roger. She's a lot more than pretty. She's beautiful, a perfectly lovely bride. And no wonder she looks radiant. He's a very handsome man. Roger, you're not looking. What on earth are you staring at?
By the door of the church, Jan. Just behind all the photographers. The chap in the shabby grey suit.
With the hat down over his eyes?
I wondered if he'd show up here.
Why, who is he?
Arthur Morley, father of the bride.
Her father? Oh, look, there they go into the car.
And he's gone too. Disappeared in the crowd.
Yes, but Roger,
look,
what on earth?
I'll tell you over lunch. Come on. It was, oh yes, well over 13 years ago. I was still a new boy at the yard, but I remember it. And this should interest you. Arthur Morley was a painter of sorts, portraits mostly.
Yes, but Roger, why was he skulking outside the church? Her own father, why wasn't he...
Giving the bride away.
Yes. Mm,
good reason, Jan. He's just out of prison, a little over a month ago.
Oh.
Have another glass of wine. It's not bad, is it?
What was he in for?
For murder.
Murder?
He was sentenced to death for strangling his wife.
Roger.
Oh, careful. You nearly knocked that glass over.
His own wife?
Yes.
Why did he do it?
There was a quarrel over another man. The trial was a short one. The prosecution proved Morley was unreasonably jealous and with no justification. But he got a reprieve. They commuted the sentence.
And now he's out. 13 years. When it happened, the girl must have been just a child.
About 10.
Same age as Scoopy. What became of her?
As I remember, she went to some distant relatives. And judging by the look of her today, I'd say there are no lifelong scars there or anything of that sort. Wouldn't you, Jan?
Well, she certainly looked happy enough. I hope she is. Really happy. If anyone deserves it, she does. After all that.
Michael?
Yes, darling?
Let's not bother with the car radio, shall we?
Anything you say, Mrs. Grant.
Mrs. Grant. Mrs. Michael Grant. Darling, are you planning to drive all the way to Devon non-stop?
Of course not.
Then where are we staying the night?
You'll find out.
Tell me.
Wait and see, Chris.
No, I won't wait.
Chris!
Oh, I hate unexpected things. Surprises and all that sort of nonsense. I got over that once and for all, when I was still a child.
Sweetheart, I'm sorry. I should have remembered.
Then tell me where we're making for.
Into the wilds of darkest Dorset. I've chosen the place specially. I came across it years ago, and I've always meant to go back. It's called Uplands, a country hotel, but it's more like a club. Tennis courts, swimming pool, the lot, and all miles from anywhere.
It sounds lovely. Hey, Michael, watch out!
The damn fool! What does he think? He can't pass on this bend. It's... My God!
Oh, Michael, be careful!
It's all right, Chris.
Oh, you just missed the hedge by inches.
Sorry.
Michael, did you notice the man in the back?
Yes, I saw him.
He turned and looked at us. He was smiling, but such a strange smile. Well, I know it sounds silly, but it was quite frightening. Or perhaps it was the dog sitting beside him. Did you see it?
No.
Michael, it was the biggest Alsatian I've ever laid eyes on. What are you doing?
We're taking a shortcut.
Oh, you might warn me next time you decide to make a sharp turn like that.
Sorry, sweetheart. I just thought it'd be a nicer run.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.